हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीबॉडी. आई एम डॉक्टर सोनिया तिवारी फ्रॉम द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कम्युनिटी मेडिसिन, अरविंदो मेडिकल कॉलेज, इंदौर. टुडे वी आर कवरिंग द थर्ड क्लास ऑन स्पॉटर्स. इन द प्रीवियस टू क्लासेस ऑफ स्पॉटर्स वी हैव कवर्ड द हाउस फ्लाय, द सैंड फ्लाय एंड द वेरियस वेराइटीज ऑफ मस्किटोज. ओके, सो एंड फाइनली अगेन आई लाइक टू थैंक द बुक ऑन मास्टरिंग प्रैक्टिकल्स इन कम्युनिटी मेडिसिन रिटन बाय डॉक्टर पूर्णिमा तिवारी एंड डॉक्टर शशांक तिवारी. ओके, सो स्टार्टिंग विद द फर्स्ट स्पॉट फॉर टुडे, दैट इज हेड लाउस पेडिकुलस केपेटिस. आइडेंटिफिकेशन फीचर्स: द बॉडी इज डोर्सो वेंट्रली फ्लैटेंड. बॉडी इज डिवाइडेड इनटू हेड, थोरैक्स एंड एब्डोमेन. थोरैक्स इज स्क्वायर शेप. The abdomen is elongated and has 9 segments. The last abdominal segment is bilobed in the female insect and pointed in the male insect. Okay, then enumerate the stages in the life cycle of this insect. So stages of the head louse, okay, are the egg, which is known as nit, nymph and adult. How is the nit attached to their hair strand? The nit is firmly attached to the hair by a cementing substance. Then next question, you can see, enumerate some factors that favor survival and spread of lice. So always you have seen in childhood also, head louse is common due to overcrowding, cold weather and poor personal hygiene. Name some diseases transmitted by the insect. So epidemic typhus, relapsing fever. Then on the right hand side you can see trench fever and dermatitis due to scratching and secondary infection of the site. Diseases are very important: epidemic typhus, relapsing fever, trench fever and dermatitis. Then the control measures are also very important, what you can see on the right hand side, and the preventive measures also. So control measures: 0.5% Melathion lotion applied to the hair and left on for 12 hours followed by washing. At the night they can apply the lotion and then they can wash after keeping it overnight. Then improvement in the personal hygiene, like daily bathing, frequent washing of the hair, no sharing of the combs and use of clean towels, clothing, bedding, etc. Then mention the preventive measures: daily bathing, frequent washing of hair, no sharing of combs, use of clean towels, clothing, bedding, etc. and avoid close contact with the person with pediculosis. So as you can see, the important questions of head louse: body is dorsoventrally flattened, thorax is square shape, abdomen elongated with 9 segments, stages are egg, nymph and adult, factors which favor overcrowding, cold weather, poor personal hygiene, then control diseases are epidemic typhus, relapsing fever, trench fever and dermatitis. Control measures: 0.5% Melathion lotion, bathing, no sharing of the combs, use of clean towels, clothing and bedding. Then coming to pubic louse, that is Thyrus pubis. Identification features are dorsoventrally flattened body, square shaped body, large legs, first pair of legs thinner than the other, large claws to hold on to a hair strand, appearance reminds of a crab. Disease transmitted by pubic louse, none known so far. Control measures similar for both head lice and the pubic lice. Then coming to the next spot for today, that is rat flea, Xenocyla chiopis. Identification features: bilaterally compressed body, okay, body covered with bristles which are directed backwards, and body divided into head, thorax and abdomen. This is quite common, okay. And I think in this picture 6.35 model of rat flea, they have made it as egg, larva, pupa and adult stages. Head bears piercing mouth parts which project downwards. The thorax bear 3 pair of strong legs. Then mention some species of importance in India: Xenocyla chiopis, Astia and Brasiliensis. Then how many stages are there in the life cycle of rat flea? So as we have seen in that picture, there are 4 stages. That is the egg, the larva, the pupa and the adult. comment on the biting habits of a rat flea. So both the males and the females of this species bite to suck blood. The feeding frequency is usually once a day. Okay, so both male and female, they bite to suck the blood, and feeding frequency is usually once a day. Rat flea cannot fly, hence it hops up to 4 inches to get into the body of the host. Now mention some flea indices used in the flea surveys. Rodent infestation rate, first, then percentage incidence of flea species, general flea index and specific flea index. Okay, so rodent infestation rate, that is the percentage of rodents found infested with the fleas of various species. Percentage incidence of flea species, that is the percentage of fleas of each species per rodent. General flea index means number of fleas all species found per rodent. And specific flea index means number of each species of flea found per rodent. Again, I am repeating the flea indices which are used. Rodent infestation rate, that is the percentage of rodents which are found infested with the fleas. Percentage incidence of flea species, that is the percentage of fleas of each species per rodent. General flea index means the number of fleas all species found per rodent. And specific flea index means number of each species of flea found per rodent. What is the public health importance of flea indices? A high flea index does not directly indicate an imminent epidemic of plague. Okay. These indices are a measure of potential of explosiveness of an epidemic of plague if an infection is introduced. Specific flea indices are more significant for the above purpose than the overall flea index. Enumerate the disease transmitted by rat flea: bubonic plague, endemic typhus, shigellosis, and hymenillopsis diminuta. Mention modes of transmission of disease by the rat flea. So biting, bubonic plague, mechanical transmission, shigellosis, feces, inoculation of rickettsia present in the flea feces into the skin by scratching action, then by accidental ingestion of flea, hymenolopsis diminuta. Okay, so biting can be there, mechanical transmission, feces, and accidental ingestion. Control measures, if you talk about, they are very important. The insecticides used are 10% DDT dust, 2% diazinon spray, and 5% melathion spray. Flea repellent is dry ethyl toluamide. Rodent control, this should follow the flea control measures. Is rodent control advocated during an epidemic of plague? No. The killing rats can be dangerous during an epidemic of plague. It is because the fleas quickly leave the dead rats and start attacking the humans. Thus, there may be increased transmission of the disease. Okay. So you can see the stages are egg, larva, pupa and adult. Both male and female, they bite to suck the blood. Then rodent infestation rate we see, percentage incidence of flea species we are going to see, general flea index and specific flea index. Then you can see the mode of transmission is by biting, mechanical transmission, feces and accidental ingestion. Then dust control measures like 10% DDT dust, 2% diazion spray, 5% melathion spray. All these are very important. Then I think we can cover two more spots. That is the tick, heart tick. Okay. Identification features of heart tick: oval body, no clear distinction of the body into the head, thorax and abdomen, 4 pair of legs, no antenna, dorsal surface covered with chitinous scutum, head visible from above. So in the flea and in the louse, we have seen head, thorax and abdomen, the body is divided. But in the tick, the body is not divided into head, thorax and abdomen. Name the genera of heart ticks that are of medical importance. So derma, center, andersoni and hemophilisis spingera. enumerate the disease transmitted by heart tick. So tick typhus, viral encephalitis, viral hemorrhagic fevers, KFD, tularemia, tick paralysis, and human babesiosis. Okay, so name the disease transmitted. Again, I am repeating, they are tick typhus, tick viral encephalitis, KFD, viral hemorrhagic fever, tularemia, tick paralysis, and human babesiosis. And if you see about the body of heart tick, it is not divided into head, thorax, and abdomen, four pair of legs, and no antenna, and the dorsal surface is covered with the chitinous scutum. Okay, then the next spot is the soft tick. That is the identification feature of the soft tick, that is the oval body, no clear distinction of the body into head, thorax, and abdomen. Four pair of legs are there, no antenna, no chitinous covering, head not visible from the above. Okay, so soft tick, you can see it is the oval body, then again it is not distinguished into head, thorax, and abdomen, four pair of legs, no antenna, but no chitinous covering. Then name the genus of soft tick, that is of medical importance. So it is Ornithodorus mau beta, and diseases transmitted are Q fever, relapsing fever, and KFD. Whereas in the, this is about the soft tick, and if you see heart tick, we have viral encephalitis, viral hemorrhagic fever, tularemia, tick paralysis. Viral you have to remember, okay, encephalitis and hemorrhagic fever. Whereas here you have, in the soft tick, we have Q fever and the relapsing fever. So, and the feature of tick, distinguishing feature ki head, thorax or abdomen mein body divide nahi hogi, four pair of leg honge aur koi antenna nahi hoga. Hard tick hoga to scutum hoga, ek chitinous covering, aur soft tick hoga to wo bhi nahi hoga. Theek hai? Then the last spot, I think it is itch mite sarcoptis scabi. Identification feature, the body is globular in shape, no demarcation into cephalothorax or abdomen. Body surface has folds and covered with the short bristles, four pair of legs, two pair in the front of the body and bear the tubular ends, suckers, two pair behind, and these end in the long bristles. Stages, you can see it is egg, larva, nymph, and adult. What is the public health importance? It causes scabies, which is the first disease of mankind with a known cause. Scabies leads to dermatitis due to secondary bacterial infection. Okay, so it causes scabies, which is the first disease of mankind, which is with a known cause. Then enumerate the body parts that are commonly affected. So hand and wrist, extensor aspect of the elbows, axilla, buttocks, lower abdomen, feet and ankles. Okay, then enumerate the mode of spread of the itch mite. It is close contact, contaminated clothes and bed linen. Then comments on the step of control of scabies. So all the members of the affected household must be treated simultaneously. Then before the application of sarcopticide, a thorough scrub should be given with soap and hot water. Or one of the following scarcopticides is then applied on the body, that is benzyl benzoate, gamma, SCC, okay, in coconut or vegetable oil, tetmosol or sulfur ointment. So this is about the scabies. It is very easy. You can see the body is globular in shape, two pairs, four pair of legs, two in the front, two in behind. Stages are same, like egg, larva, nymph and adult. It causes the scabies, first disease with a known cause. Then certain body parts which are affected are hand and wrist, extensor, elbows, axilla, buttocks, lower abdomen, feet and ankles. Then close contact and contaminated clothes and linen is the most common mode of spread. And if you talk about the control, you have to wash with the sarcopticide, like benzoyl benzoate, gamma, SCSC in coconut or vegetable oil, tetmosol solution and sulfur ointment. Okay, and before that you have to scrub it with soap and water. Then of course the last spot is the cyclops, that is the water flea. Identification, you can see it is a pear shape and it has got a tail. Okay, it is the most distinguished. अच्छे से पहचान सकते हैं हम, एक पियर शेप का रहेगा, एक टेल रहेगी, ठीक है. 2 pair of antenna, 5 pair of legs, single pigmented eye. In the female, there are bag-like ovisacs on both sides at junction of cephalothorax and abdomen. Then what is the public health importance of cyclope? The cyclope transmit the guinea worm disease, dracunculiasis. It is the intermediate host of the parasite. WHO declared India as free of guinea worm disease in 2000. Name the disease transmitted, guinea worm disease hai, ya fish tapeworm infestation bhi kehte hai, theek hai? कंट्रोल मेजर्स में फिजिकल कंट्रोल, केमिकल कंट्रोल एंड बायोलॉजिकल कंट्रोल. बायोलॉजिकल सबको पता है, गैम्बूसिया फिश, ठीक है. केमिकल में क्लोरीनेशन आ गया, ठीक है, लाइम हो गया, अबेट हो गया. और फिजिकल में यू हैव टू बॉयल द वाटर बिफोर ड्रिंकिंग और यू हैव टू स्ट्रेन द वाटर विद अ क्लोथ बिफोर ड्रिंकिंग. ओके, सो अगेन आई एम रिपीटिंग, द साइक्लोप्स पियर शेप बॉडी, टेल इज देयर, 2 पेयर ऑफ एंटीना, 5 पेयर ऑफ legs and single pigmented eye. Cyclope or guinea worm disease is caused, and WHO declared India free of guinea worm in 2000. Then you have control measures like physical measures. You can strain the drinking water through muslin cloth, boil the water. Chemical measures, you have chlorination, lime, abate, and biological, you have gambusia fish. And legislative control is also there, that is abolishing the step wells. Now, what is the permanent method to control guinea worm disease? Permanent, if you talk about, the permanent method to control the disease is by providing safe drinking water, such as pipe water supply or sanitary wells to 100% population. Okay? So, not two, but we have covered more than two. And I hope here I finish with the spotters on entomology. Okay, we have seen about the mosquitoes and their various species. We have covered housefly, sandfly, and this third class we have covered many short spotters on entomology, like we have covered the louse, then hard tick, soft tick, rat flea, then mites, and last we have covered the cyclopes. If you have any doubt, please go through the previous videos and do come with your queries. Thank you. Have a nice day.